front of God on this one. What you gonna do now, God? He said, I'm gonna forgive him. Oh my God. I said, man, all but God will. If you can realize and put God where He belongs, you can get forgiven. You can have it going on. Man can still be pouting about it. It never said that his mama ever talked to him again, but God and him was cool. You killed one of mama's babies. It might not work out for you as far as that relationship, but if you get the relationship right with God, you can still have a good time. So we didn't read that. Better watch out, mama.
Amen.
It don't even mention her. She must have flipped out. I was trying to read what did Eve think about that? You can't see it. The Bible wouldn't even write it down. We're not going to put that in the Bible. We're going to let that go. We're going to talk about Cain and Abel. When they bring Eve back in, it don't bring Eve back in until it says that, and God gave her another man.
Right.
I said, before we talk about her again, we're going to put this fire out. Amen. Eve all right now. It's all good now. Amen. A lot of times, you might think, well, why doesn't God revenge Abel? He doesn't have to. Because when you study your Bible, you realize that to be absent from this body is to be present with the Lord. David makes it clear. He says that in the presence of the Lord is fullness of joy. Like we talked before, when people think they're doing you bad, they're really pushing you into what God wants you to do. And so, although Cain knew it was bad, God said, don't even worry about it. You just don't get to be with me. David let us know that in the presence of the Lord is not only just fullness of joy, but he said they're pleasures evermore. Not that it's boring being with God. Not that it ain't nothing to do being with God. God got some stuff he didn't even tell you. You think you can get high down here? You ain't got high. God got some stuff he didn't even tell you. He didn't tell you about it. He said, this is blowing your mind. I ain't even going to tell you when I got heaven. Y'all tripping off having a little bit of alcohol. I got some stuff that when I touch you, you'll never come down. We look at Peter who denied us. And we look at how God deals with stuff. And I always say, so start looking at God from an eternal perspective, because God knows before you do, and he's already counted on what you're going to do. Matter of fact, it was written down that he was going to smite the shepherd and the sheep were going to scatter. We just read that. He was going to smite the shepherd. That's written down. It was a prediction. We could have read it ourselves. It's about time for us to start running. Because it was written before they even, that's cold. Not just he told them and they had to wait and see, but it was written. He said, it is written.
Yeah. Yeah.
What's going to happen next?
Yeah. Yeah.
And although you don't want to be a part of that and you don't want to deny me, you're not going to have a choice.
Yeah.
It's expected that y'all going to fall.
Wow.
See, it kind of reminds me of a baby learning to walk. They tell you that falling is a part of a baby learning to walk. You can't save them from that ugly process. How can I say it? You just don't want to be that baby that falls on purpose. Because then your parents just ignore you. That's just Junior. Running in the walls. That's how he play. You hear what I'm saying? You be this. God. I can't help how God give it to me. That's what I give it to me. So he says, when I teach the beauty of God and what he's done, your heart, whether it be righteous or wicked, whether it loves God or just looking for a way to go do wrong, that has nothing to do with me. You take it how you take it. I can't control how you receive it. I can only preach the truth. So based off your heart, whether your heart be good, pure, or whether it be ugly or wicked, you will come up with a revelation from what I say. So when I tell you that God knew they was going to fall before they fell, and God wanted, needed them to fulfill the scriptures, or he would be alive. Somebody else might take that and say, it's all right to fall. That's a wicked heart.
It's all right to bump
head. Yeah. You don't use it as a thing so you can go sin. You use it as a thing so you can get back up. When you see the Bible says in Romans the 6th chapter, shall we continue in sin that grace may abound, letting you know exactly what I'm talking about. It says, yeah, you're going to make mistakes, but grace is covering you when you make the mistakes. It says, know ye not that as many as serve the Lord, whoever you serve, that's whose servant you are, whether you serve Satan or whether you serve God. If you use that scripture to do wrong, then you're a servant of Satan. If you use that servant to get up and try again and do right, you're a servant of God. Amen? Because I wanted to set this up before I go into it, because it can sound crazy what I'm going to say next. But it's true. And so it says, Peter, you're going to deny me 3 times. I already know about your sin. I already know you're going to fall. I already going to know you're going to mess up. You just got to take that into the day. I already know you're going to get high. I already know you're going to drink. Are you going to sleep with her? I know you're going to live with him. He's your boyfriend. You're going to say you're married. And you're going to do all this other stuff. But in the ending result, it's going to work out just about. It's going to work out the way I want to work out. Because I'm God, I predestinate you. And all this stuff that my children go through, I've already accounted for it because your steps are ordered. Because the hairs of your head are numbered. If you can look at me numbering a hair, a particle, you must know that I ordered your steps. You got to know I looked at the next one you would take. And I love God, because if he's truly your father, if you were going to take one that I really don't want you to take, I know how to get in and make it happen. I know how to intervene too. I know how to keep you on the right track. And so Peter denies him 3 times. And it was something that struck me real funny when he told him, you're going to deny me. He said, Peter, Satan has desired to have you. I even know what Satan want to do to you. But I prayed for you. Jesus said, he wanted you, but I prayed for you. Let me tell you what I prayed, Peter. I prayed that your faith wouldn't fail. Then he said something through me off. So when thou art converted, strengthen your brother. Wait a minute, why he need to be converted? Because I didn't pray that he wouldn't fall.
Yes.
I prayed that his faith would work after he fell.
Wow.
I prayed that his faith would do what it was meant to do.
Yes.
That his faith would kick in.
Yes.
And pick him back up.
Yes.
And turn him around. That's what I prayed. The fall was necessary. If I didn't want him to fall, I would have prayed. I prayed that you wouldn't fall. I didn't pray that. I prayed that your faith wouldn't fail. And I know what I pray for. So I even told you. So when your faith works and you are converted, go back and strengthen your brothers. Because they're going to be out doing some of everything too. And I want you to know, now the faith is the believing the word of God to the point of action. So what Peter believing in order to have faith? What he's telling them right then and there. Jesus is giving him the word of God to believe. He said, you're going to fall, but you're going to be okay. today, I'm praying that you'll be able to believe my word, and it'll let you get back up. Somewhere along the line, you'll go, wait a minute, he said I would do this.
Yeah.
Wait a minute, ain't this what he predicted? But why not write it all the way out? Because he said I would be okay. And he said I would have so much strength and power, I'd be able to go back and get there. I can't quit. I can't stop.